It's another beautiful Sunday afternoon. This is Robin Bynes. Welcome. My name is Iggy Taubuchen. Thanks a lot for joining us. A lot has happened in the last week. I always like to start off with looking back at the week that was, and a lot of realignments, especially in the political arena. We will be watching closely what happens in this new week. Of course, we did hear that former Vice President Atiku Abubakar officially launched his campaign for president yesterday in Yola, Adamawa State. We're also hearing a lot of talks about people, you know, decamping from the ruling party to the opposition, from the opposition to the ruling party. There's a lot happening. Osun State, of course, did hold their primaries, the PDP, that is, and the quote-unquote dancing senator Adeleke is the candidate for the PDP, and that will probably be the last test for the Independent National Electoral Commission before the 2019 elections next year, where we'll vote for basically a new leadership and executive legislature across the country. It's also an era where a lot of things get thrown out on social media, and thanks or no thanks, I don't know, to the President of the United States, fake news has become a very, very famous or popular phrase across the world. And we're going to be touching on that a bit with my first guest here today. I have you with me, Tosin Ajibade, founder of Olori Supergirl. Thanks for being here today.
Thanks so much.
She's a blogger and, of course, amongst many other things, social media influencer. Thanks for being here.
Thank you.
I just want to start off with that now, because especially in the political arena, it's become very famous, you know, where people sort of see things or put out information unverified. And most times you guys get blamed a lot.
Yes.
That's talking about bloggers now.
Yes.
How real is this as a problem?
Okay, so for us, we get the backlash if it's fake news.
Yeah.
And then maybe when the news is not even verified before we put it out, it becomes something else for us. So we actually face these things, you know, from people when they come back to us and say, oh, this is untrue.
Yeah.
You're not supposed to do this. You're supposed to verify it before you publish. And also, yes.
Yeah. What do you do with your own company now on your own? Do you verify? Because I know it's really a race to put out news first.
It is. It's actually first to publish and all of that. Exclusive, in quotes. But for us, yes, it's a race, and we usually try as much as possible to make sure that we put the news out there so that people don't go elsewhere to read the news. And then, yes, we verify some stories before we put them out.
Some
of the stories.
So when you find out, you know, you put out something and you find out that over time maybe it was wrong information,
we'll pull it down.
Okay,
we'll pull it down and then apologize. It has happened several times. You know, there are some stories that maybe are not verified, or maybe someone pulled from somewhere, and then maybe it's what's really happening, you know, at the time. So even once it's untrue, we just take it down and then we apologize.
Are you ever worried about lawsuits, maybe?
Yes, I used to before, but now I'm not.
Why not?
I don't know how to explain it, but really I'm not, because now we are being careful, you know.
Okay.
Then it's more or less like you're just doing it because you want to.
Yeah.
But now you're doing it because, so yes, you have your brand to protect, and you also have people that you that follow you, so you just do it with caution, and then whatever it is you're putting out there has to be at least 90%, if not 100% true.
Yeah. You, of course, like a blogger, you've been doing this for how long now?
So I've been blogging for 8 years, then social media influencer for 10 years.
Yeah. Why social media? Because, I mean, you have a lot of bloggers who have their own blogs or websites. But you are heavily sort of strong on social media, Instagram, Twitter in particular. Why the focus on social media?
So social media is actually the easiest way to put out any form of advert, product or services. And that's actually the best way to get people to buy into what you're selling. And then for everyone who is online, who is an influencer, or anyone who is actually doing the business of social media influencing, we all have a different niche. We also have a different following. We have different ways how we engage our followers online. So I am different from the next person. The next person is also different from the other person. So it depends on how you engage your followers online.
Okay. Do you find that's easier for you?
It's much more
easier. Some people have said now that blogging traditionally is no longer the way it used to be. Wants to go to a website anymore.
To read.
Because information is at your fingertips.
Instagram took over. Like the rise of Instagram blogs, you know, started I think 2 years ago. And of course, you know how popular some blogs are on Instagram, in quotes. So nobody wants to go to www. To go and read the rest of the story. Just tell us here. And you know, Nigerians, they are actually most times in a rush to do things. So by the time they read the caption, they want to read the rest. They don't want to go to click the link. So yes, I really agree that blogs today, or websites today, are actually struggling to get that heat, to get to the way it was before. It's not really the way it is today.
So is it dangerous, though, that it's so heavily dependent on social media? Because if you wake up tomorrow now and Instagram is gone, what happens?
yes, I think everyone is saying that at the end of the day, you own your business, you also own your audience. So the way you can actually convert your online followers is to have them in an email list, so that at the end of the day, you know you don't lose so much people when Twitter, for instance, says, oh, okay, we're shutting down.
Yeah.
You know, Snapchat, we've seen a lot of social media platforms that, you know, come and then
they
don't even last that
Snapchat
long.
Barely lasts. I mean, it's still there, but I don't know that people are
people just go there to use the filter and that's it. You just go there to use the filter, save, and then they go on Instagram and then post. They don't even use Snapchat anymore.
Yeah. I can't talk about social media and blogging, of course, without talking about trolling and basically cyberbullying.
Yes.
And it's also something that bloggers and blogs get accused of a lot, and rightly so, to be honest.
Yes.
Because, I mean, we visit all of your pages on social media and sometimes your blogs, and we see these comments, and it's almost... I mean, I've even heard some bloggers say, of course, or offline, that, you know, sometimes it's deliberate because it's nice for their business when there's that sort of engagement. And
it's the same way they're trying to convert traffic that they're not getting on the website to get them to get the same traffic on Instagram, for instance, or maybe a Twitter thread or something, so they can get the retweets and all. So cyberbullying, yes, it has been there for a long time. I think maybe because Instagram is now more videos and then visuals, and people are now taking it so serious. It has always been there from Facebook, from Twitter. I mean, if you're on Twitter, maybe 2009, 10, 11, 12, and you survived during that period, then you should actually call yourself a strong person. You know, so what they are doing today on Instagram is actually nothing compared to what has been happening from Twitter. So cyberbullying has always been there.
But you feel like bloggers or blogs encourage it?
Some people encourage it, and some don't even encourage it. And even sometimes some say, just keep the comments clean, do not abuse, do not troll, or do not abuse the person in quotes, maybe whatever the story might be. You know, some don't encourage and some encourage it.
What's the Lori Supergirl's policy on trolling? Because I, I, I it's a very it's a